Over now to the Pogo fiasco. As the Senate wraps up its inquiry, the big question remains, is dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go really a spy? The National Intelligence Coordinating Agency says they cannot confirm this yet, but they do know that Go is an agent of influence. Go, who was absent from the last hearing, is suspected of being a Chinese spy after an Al Jazeera documentary revealed her alleged ties to Xi Jinping, a self-confessed Chinese spy detained in Thailand. Go is also facing charges of graft, qualified human trafficking, money laundering, and tax evasion related to illegal gambling activities.
She uses her influence, her stature, or her position to influence public opinion or decision-making to produce results beneficial to the country whose services they benefit from.
Go Huaping, sisiguraduhin ko na hindi ka na makakaulit dito at matututo ang lahat sa gagawin sa'yo.
Since the committee was unable to get in touch with Xi, it instead presented Wang Fugui, a Chinese national who was a former cellmate of Xi.
What did you mean when you said there are many spies and they're not all Chinese?
They are not only targeting Chinese, but they are also targeting some Filipinos or other members in the government.
You also mean that there are Filipinos working against the interests of the Philippines?
Yes, that is correct. Based on the information that is provided by Mr. She.
Also during the hearing, Nika confirmed the presence of Chinese malign influence and foreign interference activities in the Philippines, with no region being exempt from its reach. Malacanang hits former President Rodrigo Duterte for urging the Philippine military to withdraw its support from the Marcos administration. A Justice Department official also believes Duterte's remarks are borderline seditious. This report.
Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin sees a selfish motive behind former President Rodrigo Duterte's call for the military to overthrow the Marcos Jr. administration. He believes the former president's real aim is for his daughter, Vice President Sara Duterte, to take over the government. Bersamin claims the former president will go to great and evil lengths for his plan to succeed, including insulting the AFP by asking them to betray their oath. He urges Duterte to respect the Constitution and not disobey it, adding that Duterte should desist from being as irresponsible as he has become. In a recent press conference, Duterte said that only the military can correct the fractured governance in the Philippines, citing the widening rift between President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his daughter. He also asked the armed forces how long it would continue supporting Marcos, whom he again accused to be a drug addict. Bersamin finds it surprising that Duterte would make a brazen call for the military to launch a coup d'etat to unseat Marcos Jr. The Justice Department, for its part, says Duterte's statements are bordering on sedition and will be investigated.
There is no such thing as a fractured governance, whatever that means, coming from the former president. And the military has no role whatsoever in civil governance except to protect the people. For him to invite the military to have a part in seeking remedy is bordering on sedition and is legally actionable.
But Duterte's former presidential legal counsel, Salvador Panelo, asserts the former president only reminded the military of its constitutional duty to protect the people from internal and external attacks and from those who violate the basic charter and other laws of the land. The Philippine military assures the public there will be no need for a loyalty check among its ranks amid the ongoing rift between the top two officials of the country.
There is no need for loyalty checks Our chief of staff has already stated that he trusts that each soldier will perform its mandate accordingly and remain professional. Ang amin pong loyalties is to the flag and to the Constitution, and we adhere to the chain of command.
At least one lawmaker expressed her disappointment on Duterte's latest remarks. Nueva Ecija 3rd District Representative Rosana Vergara hopes Duterte would emulate his predecessor, the late President Benigno Aquino III.
Former President Aquino kept his opinions to himself, even as our former President Duterte verbally attacked VP Leni, wishing her death, mamatay ka na, referring to her as a colossal blunder. So many statements unbecoming of a duly elected president to an elected vice president.
Vice President Sara Duterte given until Friday to explain her alleged assassination plot against President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos, and House Speaker Martin Romualdez. The National Bureau of Investigation served a subpoena for Duterte at her office in Mandaluyong. The investigation also includes the hitman allegedly hired by Duterte to carry out the killing.
Siya nagsalita na siya papapatay niya si Presidente. Kailangan patayin si Presidente, si First Lady, and the Speaker. Saan nanggaling sa kanyang bibig yun? Siya yung, kumbagay, mastermind. Siya yung nag-utos. So, yan ang gusto naming i-clarify. Ang video niya kasi, ang salita niya, no joke, twice. No? Kaya seriously, kinukonsider namin. Hindi namin matake that lightly. Tatanungin namin si Vice President, Ma'am, sino ba yung kinontrata mo na yan? Well, lahat kayo, lahat tayo, alam natin, hindi i-divulge yan. But then, we'll just try.
Meanwhile, the Vice President reiterates her statement was maliciously taken out of logical context.
Tossing the word assassin into this issue makes things even more terrifying for our country, and especially because I never used that term during my recent consternation against the Marcos administration's failure to serve the Filipinos while it masterfully persecutes political enemies. Common sense should be enough for us to understand and accept that a supposed conditional act of revenge does not constitute to an active threat. This is a plan without a flesh. So, my question now to the administration, is revenge from the grave a crime? So I have to die first. They have to kill me first. They have to kill me first. So now they can't kill me anymore. Unless they want to die.
It's not yet clear if Duterte will appear on Friday, as it coincides with another hearing at the House of Representatives. The Philippine Supreme Court receives an anonymous complaint asking it to revoke the lawyer's license of Vice President Duterte. The High Court's spokesperson says the sender wants the Vice President disbarred for threatening to exhume the remains of the late President Marcos Sr. and having these thrown into the West Philippine Sea. Vice President Duterte previously said she would do this, supposedly because of the political attacks by the Marcos administration. The Supreme Court says the High Tribunal has yet to act on the complaint. The Vice President still has a pending disbarment case in the Supreme Court for assaulting a sheriff in 2011 when she was Davao City Mayor. The Philippine Senate approves the proposed 6.35 trillion peso spending plan for 2025 on final reading. But it leaves the controversial budgets of the Office of the Vice President and the Cash for Aid Program, ACAP, to BICAM deliberations. Senate Finance Committee Chairperson Grace Poe explains they need to consult their counterparts in the lower house on those items. According to Poe, the Senate's version of the 2025 General Appropriations Act is a recalibration of priorities. Poe's committee earlier said it recommended 164 billion pesos in adjustments to the proposed budget. It upheld the House's approved budget of over 10 billion pesos for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s office, as well as the reduction of 1.3 billion peso in the proposed budget of the OVP, which is at 733 million pesos. The Philippine Development Budget Coordination Committee set to review economic growth and fiscal targets next month. That's according to the country's budget chief, Amina Pangandaman. This comes after the Philippine economy slowed sharply in the third quarter to 5.2%, bringing the year-to-date average to 5.8%. That's below government's 6-7% full-year target, Pangandaman says. Possible revisions will also take into account the potential impact of Donald Trump's re-election and the weakening of the peso against the U.S. dollar. But Pangandaman maintains they remain confident the country will hit its growth targets for the year.
Based on the numbers, the agencies are utilizing their budget now. All the programs and projects of infrastructure and social, lahat umaandar sabay-sabay. So, you know that that will contribute a lot also to our growth.